In the last section, we talked about modeling an epidemic with the SIR model. Now, to make sense of that, we needed to use some mathematical language. So now we're going to take a detour and discuss that language. Basically, what I want to do is review the terms involved for talking about functions, compound functions, and graphs. So a function is a rule that assigns one and only one output value for every possible input value. Now, usually, by input value, we mean a number, and output value, we mean a number. But the input might be two numbers, or the input might be a state, and the output would be the state capital. So f of Texas is Austin, and f of Colorado is Denver. But, most of the time, it's just a number. We call the set of all possible inputs the domain, and we call the set of all possible outputs the range. Okay, so let's look at some examples. Here's a pretty simple one, the double and add 5 function. Now I said it's a rule, so it's a way of turning inputs into outputs, and to me, I always think of a machine. You put the number 1 in, and if you double it and add 5, double 1 is 2, add 5, you get 7. If you put 2 in, double it, you get 4, add 5, you get 9. Put 3 in, you get 11. And you can imagine putting all sorts of numbers in there. Any number can come in, any number can come out. Now, what you sometimes think about is putting in X. X is just a placeholder for a mystery number. It just means a number that you haven't figured. Now, if we double x, you get 2x, and you add 5, you get 2x plus 5. So sometimes we describe this function with the formula f of x equals 2x plus 5. But we could just as well have called our mystery number u and then said f of u is 2u plus 5, or called it z and said f of z equals 2z plus 5. The output is 2 times the input plus 5. And if you want to call the input x, fine. Then f of x is 2x plus 5. But there's nothing magical about the letter x. Here's another function, the squaring function. You put in negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Squaring function, we're calling this g. You'll get 1, 0, 1, 4, 9. And if you put in the number x, you'll get out x squared. So sometimes people call this the x squared function, but that's really not the right term. The formula is g of x is x squared, but g of u would be u squared, and g of z would be z squared. If x is the input, then x squared is the output. But x doesn't have to be the input. In this case, the domain is all real numbers, and the range is all non-negative real numbers. You can't get a negative number as a square, but you can get 0 or any positive number. Then we have compound functions. We have the function f of g of x, which means f of g of x. So what does that mean? And how does that compare to g of f of x? How do you combine two functions to make a whole new function? Well, here's the picture. The f of g of function means you take your number, let's say, take the number 1, 2, 3, and x. Well, you first square them, and you get 1, 4, 9, x squared, because that's what the g function does. It squares things. And then you take whatever comes out of that machine and put it in the next machine. You double it and add 5. So twice 1 plus 5 makes 7. Twice 4 plus 5 makes 13. Twice 9 plus 5 makes 23. Twice x squared plus 5 makes 2x squared plus 5. So this is our compound function f of g. And if we want to write a formula, you say f of g of x. You say, oh, g of x is x squared, f of that is twice that plus 5. If we wanted g of f of x, then we would fed x to the f of x machine first, we would have gotten 2x plus 5. And then the g machine squares whatever you feed it, so we would have gotten 2x plus 5 squared. Finally, a word about graphing. A graph is a picture of a function. It's really useful to draw a picture where you draw your inputs on the horizontal axis, and you usually call that x. You draw your outputs on the vertical axis, and you, for every possible input, you say, oh, 1, 7, f of 1 is 7, so I'll include the point 1, 7 in my graph. F of 2 is 9, so I'll include the point 2, 9 in my graph. And I just draw all the pairs x, f of x. So my second coordinate, which we usually call y, is f of the first coordinate. This was the graph of the f function, the double and add 5 function. This is the graph of the squaring function. A graph is not a function. A graph is a picture of a function. Of course, from a graph, you can read off a function. If I asked, what's the value of f of 3, I just say, oh. I just see where it is on the graph, and I read off the value. So it is a nice way of conveying a lot of information in a very compact visual form, but the function is the rule. The graph is a picture.